Alright, so here we are in round 4 or game 4, whichever you prefer, in the tournament practice room. I'm going to keep this hand. Would you like to mulligan to 6? No. Have no idea what Mr. Kobe here is playing, but we will soon find out. So, get rid of my Taiga, get rid of my foothills here. Hopefully he doesn't have Ratchet Bomb, because that would really suck. And we'll play Chalice for 0 in case he is playing Storm, Loam, or anything like that. So, yeah, we're totally going in blind with this hand, but we'll just have to see. Oh, and he looks like he might be playing Elves. So this is where the second Chalice is going to come into play, because I hear Elves like to play 1 mana spells, but that's just me. So we're gonna, should have played the Wasteland there. Oops. My bad. F6 key. Really should be paying more attention. Look, F2 now, so you guys know that I'm not gonna be skipping turns right now. Not gonna attack with the Elves. Apparently, Burning Wish, Forgotten Cave. What do we want to do here? I think we can safely play the Crusher here. We have double mocks, and unless he'll probably want to take out the Chalice before he takes out one of our diamonds, so I think it's pretty safe, and plus we can Burning Wish for Life from the Loam, which is pretty good. Yeah, so we're going to draw Life of the Loam, so we don't need to worry about that. And we draw Maelstrom Pulse. So I am going to cycle the Forgotten Cave here. Pump our dude up some more. We get another Maelstrom Pulse, which is really awesome. And I'm going to attack with the Crusher and see what he does. He'll probably just let it through. Maybe block, not sure. Obviously debating. He's going to take it. It's fine with me. Probably a good idea since the Crusher is going to get bigger. And we'll play Foothills since it makes Crusher bigger. Probably could have done that beforehand, but that way we can cycle at the end of his turn. So yeah, Elves does not like Chalice, that's for sure. Going to be setting the fourth one in, I'm sure. Yeah, let's get a Badlands here. And we'll cycle the Forgotten Cave. We don't want to draw Life from the Loam. Place Countryside's Crusher on the stack first. Going to draw Witness, so it doesn't matter. No. Don't want to draw that. So I think next turn we'll want to draw that, though. Oh, I'm just trying to debate what to do here. Okay, so yeah, good game. So he's just going to call it right now. Probably smart. So bring in this Chalice. Harvest is good. I'm just trying to debate what to take out. Pulse. It's decent against Elves just because they have so many Devastating Dreams. Obviously really good. Tarmogoyf is a good blocker, but I think of cards in the deck, Tarmogoyf is the least effective at stopping Elves. Eternal Witness will, if we have Crusher out, we can bring back a card from our graveyard, so I think Tarmogoyf is the least. Confident obviously lets us draw, so take one of him out and we'll submit, and we'll see how we do there. Elves can be really explosive, so hopefully, cross fingers, he doesn't go off that fast. Hmm. you're no second red source, but we do have Mox Diamond, Tranquil Thicket, and Life in the Loam. Tarmogoyf to help block. I think this hand will be decent. Really kind of iffy on this. Oh, okay. Leyline of the Life Force. Don't know why he brought that. Oh, Chalice. Okay. That makes sense. So, but that's good that it took up two spots in his opening hand, which is a good sign for us. So, what I'm going to do here is play the Badlands, Mox Diamond, get rid of the Bayou here, and I will play, you know what, no, I'm going to sit back, I'll take the damage and cycle the Tranquil Thicket, and I can totally Devastating Dreams him from now on in the game. So I'm hoping he plays like a bunch of dudes right here, which he is. And he attacks, which is great for us. Probably should have played Tarmogoyf, but whatevs. Chalice doesn't do anything. So I'm gonna do Devastating Dreams here. Hopefully it doesn't take our land. We're gonna choose two, that way he doesn't have any mana. And we get our land, so we're safe. So that's good news for us. We'll drop our forest. Then we can... I think I'll play Tarmogoyf next turn, and then I can start Life from the Loaming the rest of our hand back. So we'll play Valakut, and drop down our Tarmogoyf, and pass the turn. Yeah, so Devastating Dreams, awesome, awesome card in this deck. I've seen many versions that don't run it. I think you should always run it whenever you're playing Aggro Loam, and that is the game. So good game, bud. Yeah, so not a Legacy daily event, but we did manage to go 3-1 in the tournament practice room against, you know, fairly good Legacy deck. So obviously Aggro Loam is a pretty good deck. I've been really happy with it. I prefer the Wish version over the regular version, and I hope that you guys were able to get something out of these videos. Remember to leave any questions or comments if you have them, and thanks for watching. I will see you next time.